Hey man, did you hear the new iPhone's gonna have a holographic display?
Hey man, bullshit.
Alright. The modern road makes peppers ghost.
So they use this effect at the Haunted Mansion at Disney.
Yeah, dude, it's the highlight of the ride. You got this giant table, you got a whole bunch of ghosts chasing tail. Yes, it's exactly what it sounds like. Everybody thinks it's highfalutin projectors or lasers or something. Turns out it's a really bright light shining on statues moving around underneath you.
Huh. Okay, and they call it Pepper's Ghost. Why do they call it Pepper's Ghost?
Because John Henry Pepper popularized it in the 1800s, but it was developed by Giambattista della Porta in the 1600s.
So how does it work?
The same way they brought back Tupac from the dead as a hologram.
At Coachella?
Yeah. All you need is a transparent surface at a 45 degree angle and some kind of brightly lit version of whatever it is you're trying to show. Now in the Haunted Mansion, it's actual statues that are brightly lit underneath you, and the reflections are what you see in what appears to be that 3D space. But for what we're doing, we're gonna take a 2D picture and reflect it to make it look like it's hovering in 3D space.
Two questions. Can we do it ourselves? And how cheap is it?
Of course, yes. And dirt freaking cheap, as long as you remember what a compact disc was.
Compact disc?
CD? The CD, precursor to the DVD. They came in jewel cases. All that matters is that we've got some clear plastic. That's all we need. We're gonna make like a reverse pyramid that's gonna sit up like a little rose and hopefully reflect four different images in four different directions. Should look like a hologram. Now, if we just wanted a tetrahedron with three sides on the top, we would do 45, 45, 90 triangles, but we need equilateral triangles that are 60, 60, 60, right? So this is just over 6 centimeters wide. So basically what I'm doing is I measured it 6.5 centimeters. There we go. So if we get four of these, we should be totally good.
Okay, watch your fingers.
Yeah, see when you push hard, you get those cracks on there.
Oh, right.
And you could just keep scoring the same spot over and over again. Go for it. Okay, see if we can kind of crack these along those lines. Hey, there we go. Look at that.
Okay. And we need four of these. These are gonna be our facets.
Yeah, correct. All right, so theoretically, let's take these four parts.
We have my horribly broken ass one.
Well, you know, the funny part is you actually do wanna kinda cut off the top of it, so I think right. We might be all right.
You wanna try to score
that? Yeah, so here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna line this up here. We're gonna score it with seven of these forward. So we did our job right. We have four surfaces, each of which is going to reflect one of four images that if you look at it from side on, should look like stuff's floating. Does that sound right?
Yeah. How did they make it back in the 19th century before these jewel cases?
They would use actual glass as far as I know. And in fact, if I heard correctly, the Tupac one was actually a thin sheet of plastic that was just tilted at a 45
degree. Like saran wrap?
Yeah, 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 basically. All right, here, you start assembling these. I don't want to get fingerprints on it.
Yeah, and occlude the image.
So here, we'll do this. All right, all right. So look at this. You can see that 60 degrees would theoretically be a hexagon, but instead we make it a 3D pyramid.
I think that's gonna work.
You think it will?
I think it's gonna work.
I don't know, man. This is a fairly low fidelity prism? Wait, a holographic? This is a...
Yeah, I don't know what to call that.
All I care about is, does it work? All right, theoretically. Holy cow! What? Wow, right?
That looks way better than I anticipated.
This is just a floating jellyfish.
Okay, I knew this was gonna look good. I didn't know it was going to look incredible.
I didn't even think it'd look good. That was gonna look terrible. Well, and that's with my crappy tape job on there. Dude, that looks awesome, that flame. Dude, I gotta show the kids.
Oh, this is gonna blow their mind. It's blowing my mind.
It really does look like it's hovering right there in the middle.
Yeah.
The only flaws to the image
are that you my fault.
I mean, our fault.
I'm calling it. This is the best investment of old jewel cases and 20 minutes of time I've ever made.
Yes. Henceforth, all episodes of The Modern Rogue will be presented in Pepper's ghost vision.
We just got to quadruple our camera budget.